So I have already shared about the examination notification, the number of vacancies, and a bit of about the IRMS. In this session, I will discuss about the eligibility criteria, the number of attempt, and the age criteria, right? So number one, what is the qualification criteria? So there are two different background students who can join. One from the commerce background. So from the commerce background, you need to either have the degree in commerce. So degree in commerce include BCom, right? And other similar degrees. Now exactly whether management degree will be included or not, I am not sure. That will be clear on the in the notification itself. But as of now, people from the commerce background, they are definitely in. And number two, a chartered accountancy. If you are a chartered accountant, it's a great opportunity, right? And if you are from the engineering background, then you need to have a degree in engineering, right? So they are primarily considering mechanical, electrical, and civil engineering. Further details will be out in the notification. So this is the qualification eligibility criteria. One thing is very clear that now for the Indian Railway Management Services, the students of arts background, non-commerce and non-engineering background will not be eligible to apply. So these are exclusively for commerce and engineering students. After this, what is the age criteria? So minimum age criteria is 21 years. And this 21 year is counted on 1st August of the year in which you are appearing for the examination. So if you are appearing for the examination in 2023, then your 1st August 2023, on the 1st August 2023, you should be of either 21 or you should not cross the maximum age limit. Now what is the maximum age limit? So the maximum age limit has been given as per the categories. For the general category, this is 32 years, right? And number of attempt are 6. So the general category person can give total 6 attempt and up to maximum 32 years of age. Second category is the other backward classes. For them, the maximum age limit is 35 years and the number of attempt is 9. That means they get 3 extra attempts from the general category. Third comes the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. For them, the age limit is 37 years and the number of attempts are unlimited, right? So the number of attempts will be minimum 6. So number of attempt 6 is always available for everyone, and minimum age limit 21 and 32 is the for the general category, right? Now there is a big question that if a student is appearing for IAS also and for the IRMS also, then how the attempt will be counted? Attempt kis tarah se count honge, right? How the attempts will be counted? So for attempting the count, there is a, for counting the attempt, there is a simple funda that if you are applying only for IRMS, then IRMS attempt will be counted. If you are applying only for IAS, civil services, then attempt will be counted only for civil services. And if you are applying for both, then attempt will be counted for both. That means a student, if he decides, if he or she decides that in 2023 he or she will go only for IRMS, then your attempt will be counted only for IRMS. It will not be counted for the civil services examination. So the 6 number of attempt are separately given for the IRMS, and the 6 number of attempt are separately given for the IAS, right? So you can take the advantage. I will tell you how to take the advantage, especially for the commerce students and even for the engineering. You know, you should use the IRMS as a pathway for the IAS. So suppose you are willing to appear for the IAS examination and your preparation is yet to start, or maybe you are already preparing for some time but you want to now get a job. So for you, 2023 should be the focus area for the IRMS. In 2023, you prepare exclusively for the IRMS. Why? Because if you exclusively prepare for IRMS, then you have better chances of clearing the IRMS. Or देखिए, there is less awareness. अभी less awareness है IRMS के बारे में. So those people who prepare exclusively for IRMS in 2023 will be benefited, and their number of attempt for the civil service will not be affected. Right? Now, if the candidate fills the form for the IRMS only, will his attempt for the IAS be counted or not? I have already given the answer. Again, I am saying no. अगर आप सिर्फ IRMS के लिए फॉर्म भरते हैं प्रीलिम्स का, आपका अटेम्प्ट UPSC IAS के लिए काउंट नहीं होगा. सो इट्स अ ग्रेट एडवांटेज. यू कैन यूज द IRMS एज ए प्रैक्टिस प्लेटफॉर्म, बिकॉज इन द IRMS यू विल ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर फॉर द प्रीलिम्स स्टेज एंड यू विल प्रिपेयर फॉर द ऑप्शनल, दैट इज द कॉमर्स, राइट, or engineering, whatever you have, right? I am the commerce specialist, so I am emphasizing the commerce, and also the personality test. So these three remain common, and I will discuss in a separate session, in a separate video about it, right? So aapka ye jo area hai, this area is common, and other area, like the only thing left is GS mains and SA. So only this portion is left, right? So this portion you can prepare next year in 2024, and you can give the 2024 IAS. So in IRMS you prepare only for prelims GS, prelims CSAT, and mains optional paper, and you can qualify, right? I will share a roadmap for 2023 and 2024 and 2025 in a separate video. Keep watching and keep subscribing for the channel. If you want to book a free counseling, or you want to know more about the courses, so we are offering the courses on commerce optional, and also the general studies, and also the integrated course for the IRMS, commerce and GS. So you are most welcome. You can phone on this phone number, or you can send an email on this email ID, right? All the best. Have a nice day.